Hello, boys and girls. Hope you're enjoying your Saturday morning. I know you're excited about working a few problems. Let me just show you. This is from the Florida Virtual School, and I posted this on Portal. And the answers are there as well, but I want you to try first, okay? So look up here and watch. Now, here we go. I want you to always read the question carefully. They want you to find angle BKM. So BKM is this big angle from here to here. Notice that the lines are parallel. So look for alternating interior, same side interior, whatever. Whatever is going to work to give you BKM. And here are your answer choices. Let's see. I guess they don't give you any choices. Okay, and I'll show you how to work it in the correction video. And the correction video will be posted either Saturday night or all day Sunday. Or both. Number two. Pause the video, draw the diagram, and let's take a look at it. In the figure below, what is the measure of angle MKJ? So angle MKJ is this one right here. Notice that the lines are parallel. So these are going to be same side interior. So remember, same side interior add up to 180. All right, number two. Pause the video if you have to. Number three. On number three, read the question carefully. Remember, if no sides are equal, it's called scalene. If three sides are equal, it's called equilateral. If two sides are equal, it's called isosceles. But you not only rank it by the side, but you identify it by the angle as well. Remember, you got to identify by sides and angles. So make your choice, and I'll show you later. Number four. What type of triangle is shown? Well, remember, there are three types of triangles. You have one that is called an acute triangle, not because it's pretty, but because all the angles are less than 90. You have one that's called a right triangle, and then you have one that's called a obtuse triangle. And remember, if all the angles are different, then all the sides are different. If two of the angles are the same, then two of the sides are the same. So try to answer that question. This one is a little harder, okay? This one, they give you the endpoint. Let's call it A. They give you the midpoint, we'll call it M. And you're looking for the other endpoint, we'll call XY. Remember, it's going to be this plus this divided by 2 equals this. And then Y plus Y divided by 2 equals the Y on the midpoint. Try and do it, and then I'll show you on the video. The next one. Here they want to know the length of the segment. You're going to do distance formula. Remember, distance formula is x2 minus x1 quantity squared plus y2 minus y1 quantity squared. So figure out the distance between. But notice, when they say length, they're not going to say distance, so you got to use the distance formula. So I hope that helps you. Do not miss the distance formula. This one right here, you got to know what a centroid is. So you might want to look in your book, okay? A centroid, what is it? And then you got to pick which one of these is the answer. So no help on that one other than look in the book. And I'll explain it to you, but not right now. This one right here gives you the circumcenter. And again, it wouldn't hurt you to go back in the book and read what a circumcenter is, and then pick your choice. And again, I'll go over this as well. This one right here, let's see what's going on. Make sure you read it. This one is basically taking a triangle and figuring out the range. Remember, you add the numbers to get the upper range, and you subtract the numbers to get the lower range, and then you pick which one is within that range. Remember, it cannot equal the upper and lower. So think about what I'm saying. Read it carefully, pause the video, and then make your choice. All right, that's all you're going to have for today, I guess. Maybe. Maybe not. Now let's do a few more. All right, look at the next one. Now I might have to make it smaller so you can read it. Read it carefully, draw the diagram, and show me your work. And then use the same information to answer this one. Remember, the bigger the angle, the bigger the side. The smaller the angle, the smaller the side. Pause the video, read it, draw the diagram, and try and work it. And say to yourself, the bigger the angle, the bigger the side. The bigger the side, the bigger the angle. That's called the converse. All right, anyhow, take a look at what's given, pause the video, draw the diagram, and try and work it. Number 12. It's telling you that they're similar. Remember I told you the trick? You put the first two over the first two, the second two over the second two, and the first and last over the first and last. And then you plug your numbers in and you start working it out. Use proportions. That should be a fairly easy one. This is another one that deals with proportions. I would pick the light gray over the light gray, and the dark over the dark. That would be my proportion. This over this equals this over this. Pause the video and read it. This one right here you want to separate into two triangles. Remember, you're going to separate it into a little triangle and then a big triangle. I expect to see that on your work when you turn it in. Separate the two triangles. Pause the video. All right, the last one. All right, to work this one, you're going to do trigonometry to get CD. Use trigonometry. Use adjacent over hypotenuse, 30 degrees, to get this one. And then use Pythagorean's theorem to get that one. You also have to find this one as well, because you want to add up these two to get the whole thing. So you're going to do trigonometry. It looks like twice and Pythagorean once. So it's a lot of work. All right, that is your homework. All right, enjoy, practice, rework, learn, and try to do your best. This has been another edition of Mr. Toops's Classroom.